Hey guys, welcome back to Glamorized Beauty by Sasha. Today will be a review on OCC Lip Tars. If you didn't see the demo video, please check it out. It's a lot of good information in there. Hopefully nothing that I'll miss in this video. So I have 6 OCC Lip Tars and I will list each one below. Also, if you go to the demo video, you'll see me applying them, tips and tricks on applying them, and pictures of me wearing each one. So I got these, and the first OCC Lip Tar I ever got was clear. I don't know why I did that. Was I crazy? And I hated it. But I got these and I fell in love. So let's just go into the pros and cons. Simple, plain, and easy. We're going to cut right to the chase. Lip Tars. The main thing is they're not a lipstick. They're not a lip gloss, and they don't have tar in them. I know some people actually say they do. They are just a pure lip pigment. That's the best thing I could call them. They're just super, super, super strong, super pigmented, long wearing, and just, that's it. So today I have on Stalker. I love these lip tars. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I will be getting more when I hit this store in New York. Yay. Let's go into the pros and cons. You must apply them with a lip liner. If you don't apply them with a lip liner, they're probably going to bleed outside of the lip and that won't be a good look. But as long as you apply a liner, they won't bleed. Without a liner, you really chance them bleeding. Number two, they dry matte, which is a good and a bad thing. If you don't like dry lips, then you probably won't like them, because once they dry and they set in, they really are not going anywhere. I tested them out. 8 hours is how long I got out of the color one. This red one I got 12 hours out of without reapplying anything. When you apply a gloss over top of them, they suck. I didn't apply the OCC lip gloss as I should have, duh, but I applied just a regular gloss and it made it look patchy and it looked like color was missing. Not a good look with a gloss over top, in my opinion. When I apply the gloss, they look horrible. Smudge. If you do like that, you are going to have an imprint. As you can see, it's going to smudge, but this hasn't set yet. So once it sets, it shouldn't move too much, but you're going to have stain on your glass. You're going to have stain on your straw. Clothing wise, I did get a little bit on my shirt and it did wash off, which was a major plus, because when you got something this pigmented, you chance it staining your clothes and damaging it, which was a good thing. As far as packaging, I would say it is a gift and it is a curse. So this is the packaging, and the size of these are 12M. So it's a good size, and it's a good thing and a bad thing, okay? You have to make sure that this cap is on tight. If you don't, you will have a disaster on your hands. So you just twist the cap off, and as you can see, look at that. It just bubbled right up. So now I have all of this product that's getting ready to drip down that just squeezed out, and I didn't even squeeze it. So basically, when I close them, what I do is kind of wipe them off. Because if you don't, you're going to have a mess. They can be very messy. So I cleaned up the top and then I'm just going to twist it super tight. These are not something that I would carry around in my purse, nor would I keep them in my makeup bag. This is something that you have at your station. You put it on and you go, and you don't have to worry about touching it up. If you wanted to touch it up, I would recommend taking a very small container and putting a pin drop full. I put a large amount in mine to take with me and it was a disaster. I would put a pin drop full. I just could not put these in my bag, because if this busted or somehow the cap got untwisted, you would have the most disastrous mess in the world. Also, these are great for mixing. I mixed a couple of them. I think I mixed the 2 most vibrant ones. I mixed Anime and I mixed Hoochie. I mixed these 2 and came up with a beautiful color. So they have a whole wide range of colors. They have a black. Sorry, I was itching. They have a whole wide range of colors. They have a black one and a white one. So if you want to lighten up a color or you want to darken up a color, then you could definitely do that. The shipping was fast. Customer service was great. Value. For $12, you get one of these. It is amazing. You get 12M in this container versus, let's say, a lipstick, a MAC lipstick here. I don't know what's the size on this. $14 for a MAC lipstick, $12 for a lip tar. That's the size comparison. So the container is about the size of a MAC lipstick, just so you guys know. But yeah, that's it. I just wish they didn't dry so matte. That's my, like, my only bad thing is sometimes I just wish they didn't dry so matte because I love a gloss. But I am going to try the OCC gloss over top, the Lip Tar gloss, I guess that's what you call it. It looks exactly like this, but it's completely clear. And I'm going to see how that works. I heard people say that they're pretty minty. They're not minty at all. They don't tingle when you apply them. They don't taste like anything at all. They don't taste like anything. But once they start drying, like now it's starting to dry and set into my lips really well. So it just doesn't feel real moist. Like, it just feels like I don't have anything on my lips, to be honest with you. You know how that feeling when you don't have anything on your lips and your lips might be a tad bit dry? That's how they feel. I absolutely love these. I have to get more for my kit. These are like a must have in any kit, especially if you're doing like extreme makeup or just if you want something to stay all day. I just love these. So if you have any question in regards to the OCC lip tars or anything you want to add that I didn't state in the video, that your opinions on them, feel free to comment below, because people always read the comments and my opinion is not going to be the same as the next person, or I might have overlooked something. So if you have any questions, feel free to comment below, and I will see you guys next video. Don't forget to check out the demo video showing you guys how I apply them and how each one of these look on me. That's it. So I'll see you guys next video.